Views, I hope you are all fine. This ultrasound video shows a normally placed intrauterine contraceptive device, IUCD, with one ovary having a mass and the other having a cyst, hemorrhagic cyst. Now you can see this is the intrauterine contraceptive device, normally placed in the uterine cavity. This is uterus and this is cervix. Intrauterine contraceptive devices, IUCD, are the one of the most frequently used method of contraception throughout the world. Now it prevents the pregnancy in three waves, that thinning of the endometrial lining, then preventing the sperm motility and preventing the implantation. You can see both the ovaries, and one ovary having a semi-solid mass and the other having a cyst with thick fluid, hemorrhagic cyst. Now there are two main types of intrauterine contraceptive devices. Now you can see this device is clearly seen as copper T. You can see this shape of the copper T, easily detectable. Now, two types of intrauterine contraceptive devices are non-hormonal metallic, that is copper, pure copper alloyed with gold, silver, stainless steel, Chinese ring, manufactured, seized in 2000, and the other are the hormonal, for example, Mirena. Now, intrauterine contraceptive device in situ, as in this case, you can see the intrauterine contraceptive device strings are used to monitor and remove the devices. The presence of the string in the vagina usually means that the intrauterine contraceptive device is in situ. A missing string is regarded as the first sign of perforation in approximately 80% of the cases. Now you can see this patient also has a large ovarian mass. This is the round to oval. The mass is round to oval in shape, is semi-solid to solid in consistency, having a small amount of blood flow in it. Now you can see no fluid is seen in the mass, and the other ovary has a cyst, round to oval in shape, having a thick fluid in its interior. That is, this cyst is a hemorrhagic ovarian cyst. Now the intrauterine device location is examined by ultrasound, and ultrasound examination is the best way to locate an intrauterine contraceptive device or a Mirena. If you are able to feel the string, then it is probably in the right position, but the only way to be absolutely sure is by ultrasound examination. Now, although the ultrasound is not required after uncomplicated placement of the intrauterine device or during routine management of women who are doing well with an intrauterine contraceptive device, it is invaluable in the evaluation of the patient who present with pain or other symptoms suggestive of intrauterine contraceptive malpositioning. Now, again, you can see the mass in one ovary and the cyst in the other ovary. Now, each intrauterine contraceptive device has one or two threads attached to it, which hang through the neck of the womb, cervix, into the vagina. You can check that intrauterine contraceptive device is in the right position by putting a finger in the vagina to feel the device thread coming out of the cervix. You should not be able to feel the intrauterine contraceptive device itself. Now the copper intrauterine device is a small T-shaped plastic and copper device, as you have seen in this case, the copper intrauterine device constantly releases a small amount of copper into the uterus. The copper intrauterine contraceptive device can also be used for emergency contraception instead of emergency contraceptive pills. Again, now you can again see the mass and the cyst. Now, the effectiveness of this copper intrauterine contraceptive device, as you have seen in this case, it is more than 99% effective at preventing pregnancy and can last for up to 5 to 10 years. As described by this patient, this contraceptive device has been there in the uterine cavity for the last 9 to 10 years. Now, this copper intrauterine contraceptive device might not work if it falls out. Remember to check for the sting regularly. Then if it goes into the wrong position, and then if it is left in for longer than 5 to 10 years, depending on the types used. Again, you can see the copper-T intrauterine contraceptive device. Now, if you are using the copper intrauterine contraceptive device for emergency contraception, you need to use it within 5 days or 120 hours after unprotected sex. As told by the patient, the copper-T has been there for the last 9 years. Now you can see the copper-T as well as the ovarian mass and ovarian hemorrhagic cyst. You can find some important information in the description of this video. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe my channel. If you do like this video, please click the like button. Thanks.